So we'll go over the course overview. So if you were in a normal lab, you would have done all these experiments, but right now we'll only be dealing with RoboStudio, and we'll do Arduino ones. We won't be going over RPy because there's no proper software that we can simulate it on. We might also do stepper motor in this itself. Robotics lab is like one the easiest lab out of all three labs, so you won't face much problem here. Okay. So what is RoboStudio? It's a simulation software that was designed by ABB. ABB, if you have heard, is a pretty big name in the robotics industry. It makes many things. So you can just visit the links that I've provided. I'll be sharing these things. So there's a complete guide about how to use RoboStudio. We have already sent the installation guide. Just go through that. So this is how the UI of RoboStudio looks like. As soon as you open it, this is what you'll get. So go to empty station and create an empty station. Then for demonstration purpose, I'll just import this robot. So how to move around? So to zoom in or zoom out, you use the scroll wheel. See? Zoom in and zoom out. To pan around, you press Control and your left mouse button. So you can pan around. And to rotate, you use Shift plus Control and left mouse button. There are other commands too which you can use, like middle mouse button and right mouse button to rotate, or many others. And if you're not comfortable with those, you can go to Files options, and in Graphics you can change whatever settings you want. See here in Behavior, you get navigation. You can set whatever you want. You can add your own. Let's go back. So that's just how you navigate RoboStudio. Now let's go in depth with the robot that we'll actually use. We'll be using the IRB2600. This is the robot. You can find the data sheet and all that here. I've provided it. So this is the workspace of the robot, as you can see here. It's just wait a second. So as you can see here, it's a six-axis robot. The first axis is over here. Second one is this, which as arrows show, it moves like this. Then third one over here. The fourth one, it rotates about this. Fifth and sixth. I'll actually show that in the RoboStudio. So let me just import IRB2600. We'll be using the 1.85 meter one. I'll delete the old one. So let me talk the robot. So this is the first joint. As you can see, J1. This is the second one. This is the third one, the fourth, the fifth and sixth are over here, and this is the last one, which rotates about this. Right, so six-axis robot. We'll be using this for all the experiments. So this is just the body of the robot. The brains of the robot is this, the IRC5 controller, or the control unit. So you operate the robot using this, and like this is just like box with all the electrical components. For using this, you have this thing called the flex pendant. This is how it looks. So the flex pendant or teach pendant is what you use to control the robot, and To program the robot, there are two ways. You can either code on the flex pendant directly, or you can externally put a rapid code. We'll go talk more about the rapid code later. Let me show you the flex pendant. So this is how it looks. I've moved too far from the center. Yeah, so this is how the flex pendant looks from front and back. As you can see, there's something called the deadman switch on the flex pendant. So there's a process called jogging. Jogging means you manually control the robot. You manually operate all the joints of the robot using this flex pendant. So when you're doing this process called jogging, that time there's something called the deadman switch, which is shown here on this flex pendant, and over here this is the deadman switch. So the reason it's called the deadman switch is you press this switch, you semi press this switch, you don't press it fully, you don't leave it like you don't press it at all while like jogging, you have to semi press it. So what happens is, when you're using this joystick to control the jog the robot, so when you semi press it, you can do that. As soon as you leave it, the robot stops at whatever position it was, even if you're moving the joystick. And if you press it harder, then also the robot stops. And that's why it's called the deadman switch. As some of you might have heard, when a person dies, when some people die, they clench their fists. So if some person is by chance jogging the robot and he clenches his fist, like he dies and he clenches his fist, then the robot will keep running. You don't want that. So you have this thing called the deadman switch. That's why it's called the deadman switch. Now we'll just watch this video of how this joystick works. It's okay if you don't hear the volume. You can watch this later. So the speed with which you move the joystick also affects the robot. If you move it faster, it moves faster. If you move it slower, it moves slower. So as you can see, left, right, to move it left, right about its axis, about its first axis. And then you can move it up and down to move it front and back. And then if you rotate the joystick stick, like if you rotate it clockwise or anti-clockwise, it'll move up and down. So that's how that works. Okay, next we'll speak about rapid programming. So Rapid is a high-level programming language that was developed by ABB itself. So here I have provided the Rapid instructions document. You can go through that. As you can see, it has a table of contents, and you can just click on one of them to go to that. Whatever you have to use for the program. So as I mentioned earlier, there are two ways. You either code on the flex pendant or you use RoboStudio and develop the code, and you can copy the code and insert it into the robot. So this is how the rapid code looks like. This is a rapid code from the first program. First exercise. Yeah. So as you can see, there's something called V and Z. V refers to the speed data or velocity data. So it, as you can read here, it specifies the speed with which the robot moves. So V20 will mean that it moves at 20 millimeter per second. And Z refers to the zone data. The zone data, I can better explain it by drawing. So if you have a point here and here, this is point A, this is point B. Say the robot starts from this point. So it goes in this order, A to B. So say I specified it as Z20. So as soon as the robot's tool tip comes within 20 millimeter radius of point A, it goes to execute the next command or the next location. So this is how it will move. If it is Z20, say this is 20 millimeter. Yeah, so that's regarding zone data. Then other main two things that you will notice is move L and move J. Move L as it might specify is to move it linearly. So if you have point A, here and point B here, if it's move L, it'll just move linearly along that path without any deviation. But if you have point J, if you have move J, then the robot would not, or mostly will not, move along that linear line. It'll move in its own manner, which I can show here. I'm not sure whether you can see this dim line here, but there's a dim line here. Destroy it. So in move L, this is how the robot moves. It moves along that specific line. It won't deviate from that. But in move J, it'll move in a curved manner, because in move J, what happens is all the joints move in such a manner to reach the end point at the same time. That's not the case in move L. I can just show this in the video. So now he'll be demonstrating move L. Some other language, sorry for that. So this is move L. See, you can see that it moved from target 60 to target 70, target 70 to target 50 in a linear fashion. Where was it? Yeah. So now he'll run it in move J. See? It doesn't follow that linear path. If you want to see it again, it moves not in the linear fashion, and all the joints work at the same time together to reach that point. So there's one more video which you can watch, just this, which shows them side by side. One second, it's an ad. Yeah. So see here, move L, moves linearly, move J, it moves in a curved fashion. See here, you can see this first axis of the robot is moving faster when it approaches the end. That's not the case over here. Then there's a command called move C also, where it traces a circular path, and the diameter is the distance between the two points. That's regarding the rapid programming. Want to learn more, you can watch these videos. Now I'll just execute the first exercise in RoboStudio. Does anyone have any doubt till now? Hello? No doubts?
No.
Okay, then I'll continue. You don't need the flex. So after importing the robot, this is the robot that we needed, so it's already imported. Next, what we need is called the ISEFI controller. I'll import that. You can move these objects by using this move command on top here. Next, I'll import, for demonstration, I'll just import this one. So we can attach this to the robot by right clicking on that component, attach to, and you just want to attach it to the whole robot. You don't want to attach it to the base or the link one or wires or whatever cables. So just click the top one, which will be the whole robot. Yes. So it will automatically fix it to the end effector. What you want to do next is you can actually create the virtual controller, or you can do it later also. I'll just do it now. So I'll just use this robot to maybe like trace the corners, the edges of this cube. I'll make a 400 by 400 by 400 cube. Try to keep it centered about the robot. So I'll 400, so I'll move it by 200, approx 200. Yeah. If you don't keep it centered, what happens is if you have a bigger block or bigger part to trace, then if it's somewhere far off, then those points won't be reachable. So if it's in the center, it's better. Earlier I had used the jog command. You know what jogging means now, manually controlling the robot. So next, what you want to do is you want to create the virtual controller. Just click on virtual controller from layout and then import it. Just click on finish. That'll take around 20 to 40 seconds to load, I guess, depending on your system.
Just a question about the system, like the application. Is it GPU heavy? We have at least moderate speeds on Intel graphics? Like,
yeah, it'll run on Intel graphics, sure. It's not that heavy at all. You can make it heavy if you want, like you can turn on some graphic settings and all that. So it's active, the controller is active now. Now next, what you want to do is you want to create the targets to which this tool will go to. So here in home itself, you'll find target, create target. So here, see, it gives you a warning. It says default tool 0 and work object 0 are selected. Let the work object be 0 itself, that's not a problem. But we don't want, tool 0 is this base position of the base end effector of the robot. Can't show here, but the earlier point, that end of the link 6. So we'll change the tool to weld gun. And once we do that, we'll create the target. That's fine. So what you want to do first is you want to, this will be on by default, so just select the part, so it'll show this icon. Disable this and just click somewhere outside. So next, click on this position thing. And turn on snap end first. There are many snap options. There's snap center, there's snap mid and snap end. Then there's snap edge. We'll be using snap end because you want it to snap at the corners. So select this. You'll get this red symbol meaning it's selected. Select this. Once all is selected, just check that you didn't click on the bottom surface by mistake. So it's all on the cube. So I'll create it. So all the targets are created. Now, next, what you want to do is you want to check whether the configuration of the tool is proper with respect to the target. So how you do that is you click on the target, right click on the target, then view tool at target. So you view the tool at the target. So as you can see, the tool is not in the right orientation. You can't get the robot to bend that down because it will actually even go below the floor if the robot has to get to this configuration. So this isn't feasible. So you want to fix this. How do you fix that? You right click on this, then you modify the target. So in our case, we want to rotate it. we want to rotate about the y-axis. So y-axis 180 degrees. So that's what you get. This is fine. The robot can reach this, right? So the rest of them still have the previous targets. So you'll copy this orientation. Right click on it and then copy orientation. Then select all the rest of them and apply the orientation. So now all the targets have the same orientation. Right. Okay. As I said earlier, this should be selected as value 1. But for demonstration purpose, I'll just select it tool 0 and tell you, show you what happens. So I selected tool 0. Now I'll teach this target. I want it to move from this point and then go around that. So I'll teach this target. Let's say yes. So now this is the target, not this point. This is the target. And that's what we don't want, but I'll just show this. So next, what you have to do is you have to create the path. So select all the targets, add to new path. Yes, fine. Okay, so now what happened was I had selected tool 0 itself. So now if you can see here, it says tool 0. Can you read this? I can't move this mouse to that point. So it says move L target 10 V 1000 Z 100 and tool 0. But we actually wanted tool, we wanted weld gun, but now it says tool 0. So you can either delete this, these things, that to weld gun, and then do this, or you can change it later. I'll show that time. So I'll add it to this. One more thing you can do to create a path is you can create empty path. Now the path name should be main. That's the entry point for all the paths. So you should either rename the path as main, or you can like add the path to, you can add a procedure call to that path. I can do this, but we won't be using this well. Okay. So now the what's it called? The path is like this. It goes to target 10, target 20, 30, then 40. But I want it to come back to target 10. So what will I do? I'll drag this and drop it here. Or you can again just right click and add to path. And here, if you can see clearly, there's a warning. This warning says that it's not reachable at that point. It says it's not reachable at this point. That's probably because the robot can't move that way in this current configuration. So what you can do to fix that is you can jog the robot in such a manner that it can reach that position. If even after you do that it still shows this, then you can fix that in the configuration, robot configuration. Next, what we need to do. I want it to start from that point, right? Wait, I moved the robot, so I'll just create a new target. So you can see here, this is the target. Starts from here, goes to 10, 20, 30, 40, 10, and then back to 50. So this is your target set. There's an error in this thing, so we can fix that. 1 second. Here, see, you get auto configuration. Just click on auto configuration and click on linear circular move instructions. So this should fix that. The robot will configure it itself to make that point reachable. If that also doesn't work, then you can individually set configurations to the target. So it was target 40, right, that had a problem. So I can go to right click on this configuration and then you can select some configuration or maybe even add more configurations. So now that all the configurations are set, starts here. So now what you want to do is you want to synchronize this code to Rapid. And select all, synchronized. So once that's done, you want to go here on top, Rapid, and under this, you'll find the code. I'm not sure why I'm getting these add code and all that options, but it usually doesn't come. If it doesn't come, it's well and good. If it comes, just delete that. That's not required. So this is the code. So I had actually changed the tool to tool 0, but I then later on changed it to Weldgun. So if you by chance have tool 0 here, you can just type Weldgun or just copy paste Weldgun there. So that's the code. That's a rapid code. It automatically comes. So once you get this, you can like copy paste this and insert in, into the original robot. But before that, what you might want to do is, as I said, zone data. That zone data you had seen, right? There were the corners were very blunt. They were like, there was a lot of curvature at the corners. We don't want that. We want it to be more precise. So I'll just make it Z10. So when it comes within 10 millimeters, it'll go to the next command. Or you can even make it Z0, which will make it move till the point and then go to the next point. I'll just make it Z10. The speed also I'll decrease. I'll make it 400 maybe, 400 millimeter per second. Yeah. So once you make any necessary changes here, you again have to synchronize this code to station. So now whatever code you have written here, that will be implemented on that side. So it synchronizes to station. Yeah, see now you can see it's more sharper corners, but there's still that 10 millimeter distance, that zone data distance that I specified. So that still slight curvature is there. That's fine and that's better actually to have. So I'll run this. Different. Yeah. So there's a robot configuration error. This shouldn't happen, but if this does happen, that means there's some error in your configuration. This is at this point. So maybe you will have to change the configuration of the robot and try that. Change all the configurations, or you might have to do this whole target part again. It shouldn't happen if you do it properly, but sometimes it does happen, like in this case. So I'll just try auto config again. Maybe it'll run. No. So I might have to do the whole process again. So I don't think I'll be doing that. But if you get this problem, you will have to do that. Should I do it again? Anyone?
If you want to, you can.
Yes.
Like, okay, fine then. Like, usually it gets resolved by changing the orientation. Like, you can change the orientation of all of them. And then maybe try it. No. So, I'll just do it again. Yeah, this software is a bit finicky sometimes. Let me just target to. Maybe the box was too close to the robot. I'll just move the box a bit farther away. That should be fine. Okay. So again, create target. Object selected. Oh, that was already selected. My bad. Snap and ah. So I'll create this. Then I have to change the configuration of this. Rotate 180 degree. Copy the orientation. Write to the rest of them. I'll create target, teach target for that. So we have that. Now I'll add all these to the path main. So 10, 20. Oh yeah, that time I mistakenly selected this as 30. So let's do this. Yeah. 10. And then 50 in. So we'll start at this point. 10. Yeah, fine. So there's no reachability error. Maybe it'll work this time. So again, auto config that worked. I'll again just synchronize to rapid and check whether the code is. Yeah, again. Put different numbers also if you wanted to go slower at some point. Okay, so I synchronize it to station again. Select all. It should work this time. Yeah. So as you can see, it worked here. Earlier the problem probably was the distance of the box from the robot. That nothing can be done, that's trial and error, I think. That's the problem with the software. One more thing, there's a warning in the output box. That's normal, that's corner path failure. You have to add some extra code in the rapid code to make it go slower at the corners. That's fine for now. So that's it, that's kind of your first experiment. So there are four experiments. We will be uploading the four pre-recorded videos. Just go through them, try them out. So that's it for this lab. Any doubts?
Where do we download this program, Robot Studio?
We have uploaded the installation document on the files tab. You can just go through that, or okay. I can just show you. See here in the files tab under robotics lab, we have uploaded how to install Robot Studio.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. We will be uploading four more videos and this file also for you to go through the links. So that's it for Robot Studio. On the last day of robotics lab, we will keep like 10 minutes for any doubts or problems you will face. Or you can anyways any day ask your doubts in the you can just post your comments there. So that's it. Any doubts right now?